These girls are frauds.
Oh, really? Have you ever seen the devil, Mr. Proctor? Do you know what the devil looks like? Do you know these girls are frauds?
These girls are frauds. Abigail wants Elizabeth dead because I had sex with her.
That's old news, Mr. Proctor. And by the way, who hasn't had sex with Abigail? Town bicycle.
She's in love with me. I committed lechery with this girl. My wife put her out on the high road as a harlot.
Do you deny every scrap of this, Abigail?
If I do say anything, I'll leave this town and smear the name of Salem.
Well, if this is so, we shall see. Bring in Goody Proctor. Ah, Goody Proctor. I hear that you're very honest. So I have a question for you. Is your husband a lecherer?
No, he's not a lecherer.
Elizabeth, I confess.
Oh, too late now.
John.
Looks like you're both gonna burn in hell for being witches. How's that sound? Now, Abigail, you're still the town bicycle. See y'all on Sunday for Sabbath day.
Hangings for John Proctor.
Why is that, Mr. Purse?
Because the hanging of John Proctor could cause great unrest in the town of Salem, and maybe we could get him to confess.
Confess? What, confess the witchery? How do you suppose we get him to do that?
His wife, sir. Maybe we could get his wife to convince him to confess so we could save his life.
That sounds like a marvelous plan, Reverend Purse. You should bring her to me, and we will see if we can get him to confess to witchcraft.
Here, sir. Here's Goody Proctor.
Goody Proctor, do you believe you can get your husband to confess to witchcraft?
Yes, I will try.
Great. Then let us fetch John Proctor. Come on, boy. Let's go. Here he is, John Proctor. We're here to save your life. We want you to come to God and confess your dealings of witchcraft.
John, you should do what you think's best. Do what a good man would do.
Mr. John Proctor, do you confess to witchcraft?
Aye, sir.
Have you ever seen the devil?
Yes.
Have you written in his book and signed away your name and soul?
Yes.
All right, then I must have you sign this confession through email so I can send it to the deputy governor in Salem.
I refuse to use email, sir.
All you gotta do is just type your name right here.
You have my confession.
No, I don't have your confession technically. I need to have your signature and everything right here.
You have witnesses. I confess.
So this has all been a lie?
Yes.
Well, I guess we're just gonna have to execute you.
Hanging?
Oh no, we got something a little bit better than hanging this time.
What is it?
Oh, well, you're just gonna have to find out.
Giles Corey, I would like to know who told you Thomas Putnam wanted more land. I will take your confession. What do you say?
Apply the stones.
Place one of the great stones upon his chest. Oh. How about now?
More weight.
Oh. How about now?
More weight.
I will take a confession, Giles. You do not have to do this to yourself.
More weight.
Gotta run out of stones, sir. What do you say, Giles? We're running out of stones. Come on.
More stones.
How many more do we got? We've got three. Oh, damn it. Giles, I'm asking you to confess now. We're having a shortage of stones in the village. You've taken up all of them. What do you say?
Bring them all on.
Oh, God damn it. Oh, I think they killed him.
Yeah, all about right. Time. We only had them. That was the last one.
Yeah, those were the last stones. And he's a stone hog, kind of like Kobe.
A baller. Stoner.
Stoner. Giles Corey's a stoner.
Because it is my name! Because I cannot have another!
Have you ever seen the devil, Mr. Proctor?